ASOT, The State of Trance.
Of trance. Live from the studio in Amsterdam, you're tuned into episode 1131 of A State of Trance. My name is Ruben Dron and you're listening to a full hour of John O'Callaghan for this takeover episode. Thank you once again for being here, John.
Thanks for having me.
A few weeks ago, you took your brand Subculture to Melbourne.
Yeah.
For an absolutely wild event. Tell us about it a little bit.
Yeah, Melbourne in the Grand Pavilions, incredible venue. And, you know, it's been a few years on the roll that we've been going back to Australia, Melbourne in particular, with Subculture.
Yeah.
Working with a fantastic promoter over there called Evolution.
Yeah.
And year upon year, they've just improved it and it's grown and grown to become its own arena show, which is just, you know, incredible to be able to bring some of the artists from the label and other trance artists over there and play to a sold-out show for that style
of
music.
Over 8,000 people, right?
Yeah, it was sold out in advance, which is the first time we've done that. So we're hoping next year maybe increase the capacity a little bit. So it's looking good for trance in Melbourne, you know, thank God.
Absolutely. Are you going to take the brand somewhere else as well, like other cities or other countries?
Yeah, we're back. Our next big one is in Belfast in September. We'll have a Subculture Arena there.
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, we'll be back in Bangkok for Subculture 2024 with another huge lineup.
Awesome. You created an alias called Key 45 with Brian Kearney. You also have a Joint Operations Center.
Yeah.
You started out with Mannix.
Yeah.
And you also have my personal favorite, Henrik Zuberstein.
Yeah.
Which out of all of these is your true passion project?
The true passion project, probably the guilty pleasure is Henrik Zuberstein.
Yeah, because the progressive stuff.
This is what I listen to when I'm having downtime or when I'm gaming. You know, I'm listening to 120 trance, basically. Mm-hmm. They call it progressive, but it's pretty much slow trance. So, you know, people like Guy J, Guy Mansur, Hernán Cataño, John Digweed, Sasha, all that kind of stuff is, you know, this is what refreshes me and helps me to get back into the studio and make uplifting trance. You know, I don't listen to 140 in my downtime. That's when
not
I'm in the
breakfast
studio. You know, it's a high energy kind of a thing, and I need to listen to other stuff in order to recharge my batteries to get into the studio to make trance. So, you know, techno years ago, I was heavy into, I suppose you could call it dark techno. Chris Liebing, that was my kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And that's where Joint Operations Center came from, because I was making stuff that blatantly wasn't trance at all and I needed to have a different alias. So yeah. John OC, Joint Operations Center. I seen it on Black Hawk Down. I was on a plane flying somewhere and it popped up on the screen, Joint Operations Center, JOC. I said, fair enough.
Makes a lot of sense. All right, let's go back to the music right now. What's playing right now?
Right now, it's an awesome uplifting track from Daxon from Manchester. He's making serious stuff right now, yeah. And up next is a brand new one from myself and Paul Skelton and Sue McLaren. It will be an exclusive, I believe.
Ooh, so, okay. Yeah. Stay tuned for that. This is John O'Callaghan live in the mix for A State of Trance.
Hey, this is Daxon. He's tuned in to A State of Trance.
this is Craig Connolly, and this is my brand new single on A State of Trance.
A State of Trance.
Stars, though your heart is breaking.